We're not going to see the iPhone 8 until later this year. But with iOS 11, Apple may have just given us a hint of what to expect. The only thing we know for sure about the iPhone 8 is that it was created specifically to run the new iOS 11. So what does this latest release reveal about the future iPhone? For starters, Apple has finally revealed its vision for augmented reality. iOS 11 introduces ARKit, a new platform that gives developers access to the iPhone's camera and brain power to identify surfaces and integrate 3D objects on the spot. When it comes to performing image recognition for AR, Apple said that the iPhone 7 is 6 times faster than the Google Pixel and the Samsung Galaxy S8. And those phones already have unveiled their AR features, with Google Lens and Bixby Vision. Given that the iPhone's image recognition technology is so much better, I can't believe it's taken Apple this long to get in the game. But it looks like with iOS 11 on the iPhone 8, it shouldn't be too far behind. iOS 11 also made the iPad Pro more like a Mac, with a dock and a Files app. So will the iPhone 8 be more like an iPad? I sure hope so, especially considering the iPhone 8's rumored edge-to-edge display. This should give us enough real estate to have 2 apps opened up at the same time, just like on an iPad Pro. And just imagine the possibilities of iPhone multitasking. You can open links sent to you in messages without leaving the conversation, watch a YouTube video while writing an email, or check the traffic in Maps while simultaneously seeing where your Lyft driver's at. iOS 11 also introduces drag and drop between apps, so I don't see why this feature couldn't be brought to more iOS devices. The last thing that iOS 11 revealed about the iPhone 8 is that we're still going to need Touch ID. There have been rumors that Apple's having trouble getting the Touch ID to work now that the home button will be part of the new OLED display. A possible solution may be that the iPhone 8 will use either facial recognition or iris scanning instead of Touch ID. But I'm not convinced that either of these solutions will be as seamless, and iOS 11 actually expands the need for Touch ID. Apple Pay can now be used to send money to your friends via iMessage, and the only way to confirm a transaction is, that's right, using your fingerprint. So one way or another, the iPhone can't get rid of Touch ID just yet. Let's just hope that Apple figures out a way to keep it in the front of the phone instead of on the back. These are just the first features in iOS 11 that seem to be geared towards the iPhone 8, but the update is still in beta, so I'm sure there'll be more hints about what's to come, or at least a few more rumors to keep us occupied.